I can breathe. I can breathe. The madman has left the box.
One box of random dinosaurs. Check. A jungle theme, Thomas the Tank, and some magic poo. Check. Some Five Nights at Freddy's toys. Check. The whole tub of my sons, Thomas and friends, take and play trains. Check. Two rare and difficult to find, Thomas and friends, take and play crushes. Check. And one Thomas and friends, take and play jungle quest playset that my son attempted to make. Check. I think we have everything we need on the table to make a nice Thomas and Friends take and play video. Okay, let's
do it.
This Thomas and Friends take and play playset Jungle Quest, a bit tricky for me to find. I've yet to build this up. It has got some stickers I've got to put on there. It has got a bit of a peculiar thing going on here. That was the trains that came with this. The constructions are a little bit unusual. Oh, yes. I've just been interrupted. Yes.
Look.
What's going on? What is going on? That doesn't look good, guys. Come on, what's going on here? Who did this?
Dinosaur.
It's dinosaur poop and it's very sticky. Okay.
Oh, great. It's still on Freddy.
Well, can you deal with that? Can you deal with that? And also, hey, let's not derail a video with poop, okay? Sorry about that interruption. It looks like the dinosaur is going in for a second feed there. No more. Oh, I don't want to know. As I was saying, the constructions are a bit different. Coloured ones, I'm pretty sure that's the first time I've seen this, and it may really help in building this playset up because there's many colours involved in this playset. So next thing for me to do, without any more poop interruptions, is build that playset there.
Dad, yep. Thomas had a poop.
Oh. Okay, well, let's get the crane in to fix that one up. Look at that, out of the poop you go. Let me get, that's a nice colour for the problem there. Get another truck. Come on, let's get this Thomas and Friends sewage works going. Let's clean this mess up. I don't want to see poop all over the place. If we're going to have poop in this video, we're going to have tidy poop, okay? Okay, how did the tidy up go? We ready to build the playset?
No.
Well, what's happened?
Look.
What? Oh, come on. No, come on. Oh, that's just inappropriate. What is going on here? Oh, these dinosaurs. What is that? Dinosaur poop. Okay. I think I've seen enough. In fact, I don't even know why I'm going to bother with that there. Why am I bothering? When obviously it's more fun to just play with dinosaurs in a bunch of poop. Well, now I understand why the dinosaurs are extinct, and when I see things like this, it can't be any good for the digestive system. I mean, really and truly, this
is... The crane
isn't going to help. Just get rid of this stuff. Get rid of it. Oh. Before I do the build, can you please get out some of your favourite taken plays for the video? I've also got a couple to unbox here. Okay, and I will take a very quick look at the back of the box here because it does show how the playset is two-level. It is also divided down the middle by that piece there. It's got some sort of gorilla head that Thomas escapes from. I don't know why, but I think one of the strangest aspects to this playset is up here, and I've just reboxed it a little bit. You can keep that and turn it into a Ghost Thomas thing, but maybe this is one of the strangest bits of rolling stock that I've seen, which I don't quite understand that piece there. And maybe we'll have a scrutiny of Thomas in this video. Yes, like I may have said earlier in this video, this playset got opened up by my son out of box, and I think he stalled when he built it because it was actually far too complex for him to build. And this has actually got more steps than one of the harder Transformers toys, so it's going to be quite curious to see even if I can do this. And it shows how you can store it here in like your classic take and play manner, which I think is very important. And then there's a how to play on the back here. Do you need instructions on how to play?
Yep.
Oh, I thought children just worked that out themselves. Yeah, you had a good attempt at making the playset. Why did you stop?
Because it was so hard.
It was so hard. Yeah, okay. Well, my son did get started building this playset. He got that piece together there and got the roof on that there, and it does something like that. Why is it reminding me of another game? But he didn't work out. I've actually just put that piece on there. And it's a bit that goes here, then there's another piece that comes in here. And this has a foldy bit there. And there's that piece there that goes somewhere like this. And it makes sounds like this when you get them in. And there's pieces like this that go into places like that. And it looks like that gets interacted by that there. And this part goes here, I think. And we maybe get a feel for the two-sided aspect of this playset when that's in there, and that gets reacted by that piece there.
Dad, I know where this goes.
Are you an expert now? Yes. All of a sudden? Okay. So he's starting to understand. Yes, that's a very important picture there. This playset has a nice aspect to it where there's two-sided play. There's one monkey hut on that side, and there is another monkey hut on this side. And you push that in like that, and you can get the monkey hut roof back on something like that. Well, that was a bit rough, wasn't it? You'd be a little bit more gentle when you're building these beautiful playsets, or else I'll get a monkey on you. I'm having a pre-play because I can. I can't help myself. There we go. Woohoo! Just trying to work out the monkey head here, and it sort of straddles in between that middle of the playset. The lower jawbone goes somewhere like that, and you squeeze it together. I can't do it single-handedly. I think it goes in there. Well, there's a nice snap there. Might be something broken. And something like that. Then there's this piece here, which has got your classic sort of folding bit of take and play goodness. And I think it goes, oh, this place that's being used already. Something like this, I hope. And up there into the monkey's mouth. Okay, and it just flies
It just looks
off.
Like puke.
Okay, that's nice to know. It seems to just fly from the wobbly yonder here. And there's an important little piece here to get together, and I don't know if I can do it single-handedly, but that piece of track there goes there. Well, there's some stackles to put on this playset. I was going to leave them off, but they do fill up the void. This is like the reverse side. That's like the ugly side versus the nice side on the other side. There's our Thomas and our very, very strange wagon pulling I don't know what. And there was this part of the playset here, which has a little train, looks like a little chocolate train in there, doesn't it? And I think, and I hope I'm right here, that that is actually a very smart idea. It's where you can clip in your Thomas or your whatever character you want in there. So it is a real nice take and play. So you don't lose your train. I don't know what you do with that caboose there. Maybe you just clip it on the back here. Very strange piece that, but I like that idea a lot. I will come and put the stickers on. I think they're gonna fill out the playset nicely. One of those jobs, just take your time, get it in the right spot. they can be devilish things to do. The next one here, and we've just had a mental blank of who that character there is. My son can't even remember it either, and I'm not even going to try and do this on camera. Maybe I should do it on camera here. Will I be able to pull this off? Oh my goodness me. I think I've actually done it. Wow, very rare to do it single-handedly. And the last decal, which has got Harold on it, I don't know why. There's always a lot of I don't know whys. Actually, goes in the other side here, next to the monkey's mouth, and it goes in here, and I will have to turn the camera off to get this one in, because it's quite tricky, because it's tied in here. Okay, I've built this playset up, and in a strange way, we're looking at the back of the playset. Well, mind you, it has got two sides of play on this. Very curious, some aspects we're going to get onto here. Let's just pretend I'm going to stow this playset first, okay? And I've actually got a revelation going on here, but it looks like we fold the green piece up, the yellow piece of track gets folded up, and then we can pick it up and stow. But the first thing you would do is stow your trains. I've already showed that we can stow Thomas then. It's actually, as I've worked out, because I did look at the constructions, there is a place for this part here, that little strange piece of rolling stock, has got a place to be stowed as well. How wondrous is that, okay? So it actually does clip in there. That's very nice, but the problem here is, and this is where it really gets my blood pressure going, is this is a very peculiar piece of rolling stock. I have never ever seen anything like it. If you've got a normal piece of rolling stock, let's just try and stow it in here as children would do, and it won't go in. Well, why is that, boys and girls? Because underneath here, these are like nearly flat-bottomed in their design. This clip area here has a raised piece of plastic, and that's okay with this piece here. I nearly said a rude word there because, well, as you can see, there's plenty of room for that to go on. Maybe a workaround, because we like doing workarounds and solving problems, is if you're going to put some rolling stock here, put it in the upside down, but it's quite a loose fit, so be careful if you're going over to your grandma or grandpa's, because you may lose a bit of rolling stock. I don't know why it doesn't accept a normal piece of rolling stock. I mean, give me a break. Okay, let me get off that piece there. Thomas is in there. In fact, let me get that back in there. Stowed away, as if I'm doing this properly, as a take and play. Fold up our green track. And we've got this thing here, sticker. What, where does that go?
I don't know.
Okay, fold up our yellow track. And I believe we're in take and play mode. Okay, lift it up.
Yeah.
Okay, there it is there in take and play mode, which is what we like to see. Thank you very much. Okay, so this is a nice take and play place that it does have a bit of folding up capabilities. My son is starting to understand how to play with this, and the next thing he's going to show us is...
how to play.
Thank you. I thought I asked for all this to be tidied up. No, it just goes on and on, doesn't it, hey? Okay, you ready to show us how to play? Oh, what's going on here? Or is King Kong attacking this place? Let me have a look at that King Kong toy. Okay, that was in those bunch of dinosaurs. That's pretty awesome, isn't it? That thing there. Okay, Kong, I've got a place for you. Gotta have a sit in the poo pile. Okay, so let's play. You gotta put your wagon there in a certain spot, don't you?
Like, it's here.
Yeah, how did you learn that? How did you know that? It goes in there.
In the construction.
Are you sure it's the right way around? Okay, well, I believe you. I'm sure the audience will scream if it's wrong. Where do you put Thomas? Thomas is coming around here. Oh, he drives into there.
Oh,
yeah, okay. You got to put that little arm down, I think. Okay. And Thomas goes up, doesn't he? Oh, very rough ride. I think the truck's gone for a spin. That's gone down there. And there was a magic edit there, yes. He hits that. Oh, okay.
And then he takes it.
To the front.
And you can go anywhere.
All right, you can go back in there.
You're
going back in. Okay, then you can go up again. You pop it back up, and I think then Thomas goes for a hell ride. Oh, right off the table. Okay, let's see that again. It's a bit strange that Thomas pushes the load in this one. Is this based off an episode or something? Okay, pump it up. There we go. Whoa! Oh, let's see that one again. Yes, it resets down again. You've got to get that little arm down.
I don't like it pulling.
And we're going to see one more time, but Thomas is going to go forwards in this time. Okay, well, Thomas facing forward. Will he work? Yes! Whoa! Playing a lot and thinking about things and the way things go, especially this wagon here. For Thomas to accept this, it has to be round that way, as strange as it sounds, and it goes in like this, and I think it holds in there. I don't know what's holding that. Is there some magic going on there, Thomas? Magic?
No, because
what is it?
Because this, like, because it's not going down.
Okay.
And there's this, like, really straight.
Now we're going to do this side again. I want to see if Thomas does trigger via this here and this here to make the little wagon traverse from there and go all the way down there to the join-up area, which is down here. Yeah, so Thomas is meant to trigger that there, which keeps that little truck rolling. Okay, we're driving Thomas in nice and slowly, making sure that little boom gate is down, thank you. And we're going to pump it up nice and slow and just see exactly what goes on here and see what moves and doesn't move. Okay, little wagon's gone to its first point. Thomas goes down. He's triggered that part there. So he's triggered this one here, which has sent the wagon to this part here, but he's stopped here. So if you push Thomas forward again, okay, then it's a matter of coming along and getting the couplings together. You've seen lots of take and play playsets over the years, haven't you? What do you think of this playset?
It's very cool.
Whoa.
And it's mind blowing.
Wow. I think it's different. It's very different to the ones we've had before.
Something happened to Thomas.
Yeah, well, wouldn't it be nice, while you got that there, wouldn't it be nice if this jungle playset came with that jungle themed Thomas? I hope that's a jungle themed one. Wouldn't it just lifted the whole playset? Just on the thought of the new style rollover squashed up version of Thomas of that dumb magnet. Let me get another piece of rolling stock. Just hold that, please.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm going to try and find the new version of the rolling stock on it. That's the old format, which had the individual bogies. They were longer, and you can tell that because of the magnets. I think I might have to get out of the garage and look for something new. There's my... You know, I might try and get Diesel 10, the new version of Diesel 10. I think I've got him hiding somewhere. The new version of Diesel 10 is radically different to what I've got in my hand there. And before I get the new Diesel 10, I'll just pull King Kong out of the poop. I dare say he's had enough. Ooh, yeah. Okay, it was like a Thomas and Friends miracle to find this. I've actually found it, so... That is the newer version of Diesel 10, somewhat downsized. Yes, okay. I'll let my son unbox that one.
Yay.
Oh, okay. Here comes Diesel 10. One of his favorite characters. It's going to be a tricky one because he wants to stay in there. Oh, yeah, look at the expert fingers. Here he comes.
I can breathe. I can breathe.
The madman has left the box.
He has his pet Pinchy.
Yeah, he's got his pet Pinchy. Let me just, what were your first thoughts of that Diesel 10? Because your favourite one's a classic one. What's your thoughts?
I like Pinchy because he sometimes he gets hungry. Oh. But because that's the way. Yeah.
Do you notice it's actually smaller than your other one?
I know.
Okay, which one, if I give you that one, which one do you like better? Which one do you, I know which one this is going to be. Which one do you like better? Look at them carefully. Look at the wheels and everything. Got different wheels, okay? Okay, had a good look. Looking at the faces and the pinchies on them. And all the details. Children, look at everything, okay?
Look at pinchies and... Yeah.
Okay, so tell me which one's your favourite one. Which one do you like best?
Both.
I thought you'd say that. Highly diplomatic, aren't you? Highly diplomatic, eh?
Dad.
Yes.
Look at the pinchy. This one can lift up.
Yes.
But this one can't.
Oh. You sure about that?
Yep.
Okay. So you still like, you still like both of them now you've worked that out. And you were talking about detailing as well. What, something about this one's got different detailing.
Yep.
So this pinchy here doesn't articulate up or down. It just swivels around. Whereas our old classic one here... I use the word classic quite fondly now on many toys from only a couple of years back. Look at that, a fully articulating pinchy, which goes all over the place. Now, which one's more fun to play with? Let the audience have their say. Which one would you prefer? Would you have it prefer a pinchy that just lays flat?
Both.
There we go. Would you like a pinchy that goes up in the air like that and does all sorts of things, hey?
Just choose both.
Isn't he nice? He's so nice. Yeah, my son was saying the detailing on the classic one's got longer detailing here. But
just these both, just ignore.
Okay. The detailing here all been squashed up. That's because we're looking at a much more compressed model. But hey, often children aren't really that picky when it comes to toys.
Ignore him.
So now I've got one of the new Diesel 10s. We're going to give it a test drive on this playset. Okay, ooh, look at the menacing there, and he's going to go around to the part where Thomas goes, just seeing if the longer format train works in this playset. Send Diesel 10 on his way to the top here, hopefully he's going to work for us. Keep going, that's it. Keep going. Whoa, he's done the same as Thomas. He's got round to that next bit, and he can connect up there. Now, will he play the full playset? Got to reset it. Yep. Get Diesel 10 in there, finally he's doing some work for us. And we're gonna see if Diesel 10 is gonna play. Let's go! Whoa! Come on, Diesel 10, come on, Diesel 10, and here he comes! Whoa! Straight into the poop! Okay, it looks like we've got a surprise one coming down here. Oh, it's... Whoa! Let's do Diesel 10 face first into the poo. Okay, so Diesel 10 is going face first and looks like Jungle Thomas is going to go for a bit of a spin as well. Any moment now is going to be disaster. Okay, here they come. Anything could happen. Whoa, yeah, and guess who's found the poop? Oh,
thinking, baby.
My son's trying an experiment at Jungle Thomas in where that little wagon goes. Yeah, so normal Thomas is going in there. Jungle Thomas is where the other one goes. And it's just ejected out the side there.
What?
Okay, let's see what happens. Okay, pump it up. There goes, and it's sort of stuck there. Doesn't like it.
Wait.
Oh, it sort of does like it. Oh. Well, it's sort of very messy. Hang on a second. You can't do that. Well, this place here, it's a bit like you stick a monkey suit on something and people look at it, isn't it? It's a bit like skulls are the same. The Thomas in this place set... get out of it, King Kong. The Thomas in this place set, I'm pretty sure that's just a standard, stock standard. I call it the rollover Thomas take and play model. It's all light now. They've squashed the cabin down. We've got less detailing. We've got magnets that aren't smart like we used to get. What positive things can I say about it? It's a lighter toy. That's a positive because the very early versions of these toys are actually very heavy. And if your child was a child that threw toys, it was the sort of toy that would go straight through your lovely TV. I just dare say we're into that whole cycle of things getting smaller and smaller and less, aren't we? It doesn't seem to stop. Thinking of less and strange things, I really do not know what to say about this wagon here. I don't know whether that's meant to roll. It rolls over that, but why? What does that mean? It's like that. I don't know. Maybe the audience knows about that. I don't know. It doesn't seem to activate by the wheels. I just don't understand this piece here. It'd be the best way of saying it. Just have your thoughts on that. I don't understand why. Now I can't get that thing back. Go away. Wouldn't it be nice if the playset came with a Thomas like that? It would have just lifted the whole game. That's just my 5 cents on this. I'm a toy reviewer. I've looked at a lot of these toys. I just think a simple change of putting like the Jungle Thomas in this playset would have really made it. Or maybe another character. Maybe you've got a suggestion of another character. But I think when you look at those two there, which one would you prefer in the playset? Normal stock standard Thomas or Jungle Thomas? Okay, I'll get my son to unbox Oliver Harvey. Some people say, oh, Harvey's a new thing. Well, no, he's not. And Philip here, that's a Thomas Wooden Railway Philip. I'll get him to get those out of the box. And while he's struggling away there, I've actually got this Thomas Minis playset here. It's not the sort of playset that I'd even bother bringing to YouTube as a review. We had a bit of a play of this. And as my son found out, he likes to play with two engines connected and it just jags up. I don't like that. And I think, this is me, just being me, I'd much prefer to spend money on something like that over there. That playset's fine and dandy, I think. But this sort of thing here doesn't do it for me. It actually folds up into a Thomas, so because I'm a Thomas the Tank collector, you can see the wheels of Thomas on the bottom there, I'd get it purely for the fact that it folds up and looks like Thomas. But thinking of minis, we'll give some minis a go on that jungle set there. So I've got Harvey there. What do you think of Harvey?
He looks cool.
He's got a very cool face, hasn't he? Do you like the way his hook works?
Yep.
You know, there was a Harvey before this one here. Do you want to take a little sneak peek at one from a previous era? Well, the new Harvey may be quite impressive to my son, but I've actually got this set here called Harvey's Heavy Haul. Remember this? Only from a couple of years back and away, but boy, things have changed. There's Harvey in there. He's actually got a metal hook. Okay, he's got a snap-on dirt pile. He's got some detailings on him. He's all muddy, isn't he? It looks fantastic, doesn't it? Remember when toys used to be like that? A lot of playability. Sort of like when they used to care. And there are also other train sets. I've actually got all these. They're downstairs in my secret collection of Thomas stuff. Look at that there. They were the good old days in a sense. And the good old days weren't that far away. Yeah, that's what it used to be like. Well, the funny thing is, if you don't know about that there, what's presented today would seem awesome, and for the fact that my son has got it there playing on the playset already, he thinks that Harvey is awesome. Oh, we're just getting Philip out, because I'm curious to see how Thomas Wooden Railway works in this playset. Can drive into those little monkey sheds he's got in there. I'm going to try and give Philip a run here, see if he works. Thomas Wooden Railway, Philip, come on! Oh, he's just... Come on, Philip, come on! We're trying him on the other side there. He only just fits in there. Let's see if he races down this other side. Whoa! He got down there. So you sort of
he's stuck in this part.
Can sort of can play with the wooden railways in this playset, sort of. Does he pick up on the magnet there? Does it fit in?
Nope.
Oh, why aren't I surprised?
It's bigger.
While we're thinking about cross compatibility, let's just try and give that Thomas there and the troublesome truck a ride in this playset. Okay, well, there's Thomas. We'll join him up to the troublesome truck. Okay, very gently because he's very light. See if he runs in this playset. I think because he's too light, he's going to jump around.
He won't jump around today.
Oh, there he goes. Oh, okay. Well, they're having a bit of a crash and bash on the way down. Sort of semi-compatible with those, but it's not a playset made for those small toys. Well, my son's going to give it another go. We've put the troublesome truck in there where that strange little wagon would go. And we're going to put Skull Thomas in that side there. And gently, I think the secret is gently pump him up. Okay, nice and gentle. That's it, so he doesn't jump around. Gentle again. And the other one's taken off like it should, which is a good sign. And there goes Skull Thomas down there. But I think the trouble is the troublesome truck is all a little bit too light for this playset. It's sort of stumbling and bumbling its way through. But children can sort things out and make it play. That's what I've like that. That's what I've noticed. I do quite like this playset. It's got a fair bit of fun. It's very nice to look at. I think for the fact that you got this two-sided escapade going on here, we've got our gorilla man there. That's the eye candy in a sense. You want to keep looking at that. It's got that very peculiar area down there where that little truck is that's taken a rampaging run there. Oh, a lot of nice things about it. You can change the playset up. If you've got taller things and you're going to play for your wooden railway on this, you can take those parts off and discard them. If you're really desperate for extra fun and play, you can take this piece off here. And I know this is what will happen. I know how my child plays. And this thing will be going around and be set up in different areas and munching and crunching along the playset. I actually like this Thomas and Friends Take and Play playset. I actually like it a lot. And with that gorilla head, I know what my son is going to do with it. It's going to be something like that. So he's got that down in the poop. And there it is there. Gorilla head, a pile of poop. And
nom, 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 nom.
Teasel 10 having a play there as well. Well, we quite enjoyed this playset, didn't we? What did we say at the end of our videos?
Thanks for pooping and bye for now.
Oh, what sort of tongue is that?
A poo tongue.
Whoa. Some of my son's favourite take and play trains. I think we have everything up on the table we need to make a nice Thomas and Friends video. Okay.
Let's do it.
And this goes here and we start to get a feel for the blah, 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 blah. Okay, have you worked out how to show us how to play or are you too busy playing with King Kong? We've got King Kong attacking the place. I don't know why. Come here, Kong. Let me put you in the poo pile.
Oh, come on.
Okay, go, Thomas, go. And he doesn't want it. That's on the far reel. Okay, there's Thomas being driven in. We're going to do nice and gently and slowly here, but you have to reset that one there, and we'll do another one. Can Diesel 10 pull this off? Ever heard of the foul rule? There's another one for it. I'm sure you can. Look at this. Straight into the poop. Ooh. Next to Diesel 10.
Nom, 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 nom.
Oh, nom, nom, nom. Okay. What do we say at the end of our videos?
Thanks for watching and thanks for poop.